Okay, now we're going to actually look at subplots. So we know how to put like more than one plot on a thingy, like on a, what do you call it? On a graph with the hole function. But we can also put more than one plot on a single window. And to do this, we use something called the subplot command. So subplot m by n gives you an m by n matrix of plots, and you put the focus on position p. So, got ourselves a little thingy where we got ourselves some, you know, points. We're going to do sine x and sine of 2x. I can even put this over here so it's even more super duper clear of what's going on. Actually, it's fine. So we got a y1 and y2, but you can also do them. I guess what I'm saying is you don't have to have everything preloaded here. You can just load it right here if you want, and that works just fine too. Okay, but nonetheless, so I'm going to run this, and I'm going to create this data, and I'm going to go, okay, create a 2x1 thingy of subplots, of plots. In the first position, put this plot. In the second position, put this plot. So we're going to run it and go, and there you go. Okay, so see, we've got essentially two plots. We have a 1x2 of plots, and each plot can be dealt with separately. So when the focus is on subplot, here, let me actually throw this over there. So when the focus is on subplot 2, 1, 1, I can put in a title and call it cheese. And that will go there. And over here, I can call it money, cheese money. And I can do things like I can change the axis on this one to go from 0 to 2 pi and negative 1 to 1. What did I do wrong? Axis, not axes. Here, but leave the other one where it is. Make sense? So like one of them can change and this one can just stay the same. I can take that out if I want and then it goes back to where it was. But it'll change this axis, but not that axis. So it just kind of focuses wherever the focus is where it's gonna be. I can make this one blue, dotted, you know, and be like line width or line width of 5, 6, 4, you know, like whatever. So, but the idea is I have a 2x1 matrix subplot in position 1. I've got the first one. In position 2, I've got the second one. And then from there, I can really just do anything I want. I could even make a separate, like a hold on here, and be like plot x sine, undo cosine of x, like that, and make it be, you know, red and line width 4. And then hold them off. So see, now they're both in there. So I could do that, and I can basically make this its entire own separate plot, sine and cosine. And this one is totally separate from this one. I can do whatever I want up here, and it's treated completely differently from what I'm doing down there. Does that make sense? Kind of? Okay. So basically the idea is I can make an entire plot like normal, like I would have done in another section. The only thing is I'm just gonna start with the word subplot. And what this says is this just says, bring attention to position 1. Okay, so, and it's kind of like given a 2x1 matrix of plots. So 2 rows, 1 column of plots, bring attention to position 1. And then this one is given a 2x1 matrix of plots, bring attention to position 2, like that. So let me put a little CLC clear up here because I don't like seeing error messages that don't belong. All right, so essentially, you can do everything you want with subplots. Now, go, have fun. No, I'll do a couple more just to kind of show you. So if you wanted to divide the figure vertically instead of horizontally, or I guess I would consider this a horizontal line if you want it to be like lefty-righty instead of uppy-downy, then really what you don't want is instead of having a 2x1 matrix of plots, so 1, 2, 1, you want to have a 1, 2, just one row. So one row, two columns. So I'm going to copy this because it's going to be basically the exact same thing, except instead of being a 2x1, it's a 1x2. Okay, so I'm going to say this again. Instead of being a 2x1, ooh, I need to do that. Ah! Whatever just happened. Undo it. Instead of being a 2x1, it's going to be a 1x2. So right here, 2x1, 1x2. And in here, instead of a 2x1, it's going to be a 1x2. So this is going to be, and I'm just changing the concept here. So a 1x2 and a 1x2. So this is a 1x2 position 1, a 1x2 position 2. And if I go and I run this, I'm going to get those vertically, or I guess however you want to say it, side by sides, lefty righty, aligned plot. So just in general, this is pretty great. This really opens up a lot of opportunities to do some pretty crazy things. Not like crazy, like awesome crazy. But for example, here, let me show you if you do a 2x2 matrix of plots. So subplot 2x2, position 1, position 2, position 3, position 4. So I think I originally put these in here as sine and cosines. I don't know if you can tell the difference between sine and cosine enough. So let's make this one like, well, I guess it'll be labeled. So I guess it's fine. You can read. I'm going to go ahead and just run it. Okay. So look at what's going on here. So we have sine and sine. So look at this as position 1 and position 2. So look here, position 1, position 2. So they go left to right. And then position 3 and position 4, again, go left to right. So the good thing is if you get them flipped, you can just run it and be like, oh, I meant this to be down here or wherever. But in general, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, blah, 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 and then 6, 7, 8, blah, 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 blah. So it numbers them in order by row. So if you were doing like, so P values would be like 1, like if you had a, I guess what I could say is if I had a 3x4 subplot. So that would be 3 down, 4 across. The first row, so first row would be P equal 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that would go all the way across. And then the second row would be P equals 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then it would be the third row would then be, I can't spell, would then be the 8, 9, 10. Wait, do I suck at adding? I do, because it would be 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 9, 10, 11, 12, like that. Okay, so it goes across. Across. Kind of makes sense? Sort of? There are some weird things you can do, okay? Oh, I'm going to show you this too, but I want to do some weird things in a minute. I did want to show you that there are some weird things you can do with strings. There's something called text properties in the help browser. Like if you go to help, there's like help. Where is it? Help. I have to find it. Anyway, I'm just going to show you this. So I'm going to do these plots. This is also a 2x2 of plots, mostly to show you that you can actually put in special characters using something called LaTeX. And it's a markup. It's kind of like HTML, but for math nerds. Anyway, you can make a pie by doing \pi. And see how there's like a little pie right here? It's kind of cute. I can't actually hover on it because it won't let me do it on doc. But see, there's a pi. E to the x, and I put it in a thing because if you do e to the x plus 2, if you put it in curly braces like that, it'll actually put the thingies, like the x plus 2 up there, which is pretty cool. So like x to the negative 1, and it whenever you draw the picture, and it'll put the little x to the negative 1. You can also use subscripts, so x sub 1 minus x sub 2 uppity doop squared. would give you x sub log minus x sub 2 boopy boop squared. And same thing if I wanted this to be x sub, and I want to call it like velocity 1 and then velocity 2 and put it in curly braces, then I could do that. So that's just more like being super duper fancy. There's ways you can be even more like crazy about it if you really wanted to. But that's just kind of the way to get started. I think that there are even weirder things I've seen people do. I feel like I've seen people do stuff like this. Yeah, so like in positions 3 to 4, make it go all the way across. So that's weird. What is this? This is crazy. I'm not sure how it would work the other direction. Like if I wanted this one to go up and down, maybe I would have to be like, I'll take this one out and maybe be like, I want this one to be in positions 1 and 3. Yep, that's how it works. So, you know, you just guess and you see and you go, oopsie, it worked. So you can do all kinds of weird little graphs and stuff like this. So whenever I have to do stuff in, graphing reasons, and I'm doing stuff in Excel, I usually get really frustrated pretty quickly because Excel only lets you do certain things, and every time you do something, you got to readjust it. And I really like the level of control that I can have with MATLAB. It's really cool, but it's the thing is, you don't really learn how to do stuff until you have to know how to do it, but just knowing that stuff like this is possible is pretty awesome.